Hello everybody, it's another Brucie-Magik video. Today we're just going to be driving a scenario that I've edited slightly for consist purposes along the North Lincolnshire route. Today we'll be going from, Grimsby, I've forgotten exactly where the scenario, to Boston. So this will be quite cool. I just want to set up my headlights. Okay, which I can't find. Great. Well, we'll worry about that when we're on the move. Or alternatively, we just do that. So, yeah, I've downloaded this route. It's the North Lincolnshire route. It's freeware. And it's a route I've been meaning to get. I've threatened to get it for a while, actually. My friend Glenn Streeter put me onto this. A very knowledgeable man. And he said, oh, you might like this. I said, yeah, I might well do. Now we could go heads out view today for maximum noise. In fact, I can turn the clack back to Control C. Oh, shoot, see? There we go, clag factor. Ah, we got clag. Yeah, that's better. Shift M. There we go. Maximum noise because we can. Thought I'd take us out along this route. We've got the reshade pack on again. From Railworks, RW Enhancer, I've forgotten exactly who makes it. But yes, interesting consist. Train is quite long, about 10 coaches more. I think the original consist was about 12. And it's quite an interesting consist. I've swapped out the carriages to be Armstrong Powerhouse stroke the DT Mark 1s. It used to be available from Digital Traction, but now available from Armstrong Powerhouse. And then we've got a bit of a bonus vehicle. We've got a Gordon Matt vehicle just here. That's a Thompson Buffet, which is from one of his BR Blue packs, which will be quite cool. Just round off the rest of the consist. And I went with BR Blue because I wanted to use the Class 31 enhancement pack, which is great, but the big disappointment is, and I wish Armstrong Powerhouse would learn about this, it needs BR Green for the reason. Because BR Green was a very, interesting era for these diesels, so it's a shame they missed it out. So we'll maximise the crash. Next stop is Louth in 13.5 miles. Oh, there we go. Style, it's quite slow. Now, where's that instrument panel switch? That's engine stop, engine start, instrument lights. Oh god, this is where I have problems. J? What does that do? Oh. There's a way of getting the instrument lights on, I forgot what button it is. So, yay me. Is it O? H? No, K. I don't know what the hell that was. Oh, it's terrible, it's blushing. Oh well, never mind. We'll just carry on as normal. Despite this being set at 08:54 in the morning, I haven't actually put on the Armstrong Powerhouse Weather Enhancement Pack yet onto this route. I've only just installed it, but when I do, it'll obviously be a lot better for daylight, and the weather will look 10 times better. about there, so we've got all the dials. There we go. This route is very, very nice. It's not just a point-to-point route. We're just looking at Grimsby on the map. Scroll out. This thing is a whole friggin' network. Immingham, Grimsby, North Lindsay Light Railway, all the way across to Retford, all the way down to Lincoln down to Boston, Skegness, Mablethorpe, Sutton-on-Sea, which is, just depicts that this route is very, very prototypical of the 1950s, early 60s, when a lot of these lines still existed. However, some of the routes, a lot of line through Louth did exist until 1981, so you can get away with the old blue era stuff on this as well, albeit a lot of stations are closed down at that point. And a bit of a channel update for us while we're just tootling and pootling along. I'm going to be moving house within the next month and a half, so I'm going to try my best to record some material, whether it be reviews, quick drives, nighttime perspectives. I'm going to upload these to YouTube, well, that's the plan anyway, on the schedule. And when this has been done, I'll make sure that there is a list in my YouTube group, and maybe some other groups as well, where a lot of you viewers come from, just to let you guys know as and when stuff will be released on stream as such, so you know when there's a video going to be dropped. I'll try and keep it an upload around one a week, or maybe two a week at most, so it saves me recording too much material, because obviously after I record it, with Light Eye Perspective in particular, it's quite a lot of work for me. I don't use AI traffic in Light Eye Perspectives. I typically drive all the trains that you see in Light Eye Perspectives myself. And I tend to find I get the best out of loco performance out of doing that. I've still got a lot to learn with doing it, but as a whole, I think they come out very well. But what is an 8-minute or 10-minute video can sometimes take me an hour or 2 hours to record, edit, chop and change, go re-record something, stitch it together in my video editor, let it obviously render it all the way through so it's a complete video, then I've obviously got the upload time to YouTube, which normally ain't too bad on those, so but it can be a lot of work for what is a very short video, but you guys seem to enjoy them, so I'll keep making them. But if you have any suggestions on what you want to see in Light Eye Perspectives, leave a comment, join the Facebook group, drop me a line and let me know. Very open to suggestions for material. There we go, bit of noise. Obviously we've got no AWS on this route, because this route obviously predated the points we're in rolling with AWS.
Louth,
could go north to Grimsby Town, south of Boston on a direct route, go east towards Mapleford and the sort of loop line. And if you went west, I can't remember where that ends up taking you actually. Just Barley, that's it, Barley. Goes through some interesting places, that's a single line route. Quite interesting grounds, station, things considered, back in the heyday of steam and early diesel history. Obviously the joint line, I do apologise folks, as soon as I've pressed my final day, as soon as I go to record the video, just lay off the power a little bit. It's actually we need to make full time, don't we? Just tell the table tomorrow. Yeah, sod it, speeding. What was I gonna say? Yeah, a lot of these lines in North Lincolnshire, kind of like joint lines in a lot of ways, especially around Ibrahim area, the GC going in, Great Northern as well. Then obviously when it came to the grouping in 1920, it was all that in the yard. But you would have seen a lot of widespread spreading around the stock of locomotives. In the 50s it kind of thinned out a bit, so there was not the standardised types. I say standardised, but in the sense of it was mainly Robinson 04s, B1s. There was a few XGC locos looking about, like A8s. J50s were also looking about the area as well. And at one time, Immingham actually had an allocation of two Britannias. Oliver Cromwell and I've forgotten the other name of people. The chap who made this route, very knowledgeable. Researched going forward into the room. He researched it extensively as well. On his website, which I'll link in the description, he's got a fantastic resource. He's got separate sections, he's got a map, he's got separate sections including histories of the line, or lines that compose this route in essence. Also has several scans of original timetables from the 50s and 60s uploaded to the website, various sections of this automated ETS, which is really useful for scenario creation as well. There's loads of scenarios on this, and there's a lot of options to customise the scenarios in this, so they use the default stock. That really ghastly RSCO coin to swap out for the GCRA cable that only works. So there is scope for it. And say watch this space, because we never know, do we? Know what's coming around the corner in train sim that would potentially run on this route. It's gonna be very interesting drive this. I haven't done all the way down to Grimsby, I haven't done all the way down to Boston yet. Well, this would be a nice scenario, it's about an hour long. Press play wings. If this route still existed, it would be quite interesting indeed. Hello, some people. But see, this is supposed to be some route at 9 a.m. in the game, and the sun should already be well and truly orbit, so there would be sunrise. So that AP pack would make a nice difference. They're close to the one night. says the scenario is going to take 60 minutes, so we've got people about Alford, Willoughby, Thursby, Boston. Boston is the stop, so it'll be Norbs to Daisy. Probably looks it froze on me. Well, I'm not going to say, but basically, I'm going to take a direct line to Boston. The route is obviously going to be mostly flat, especially around the northern parts of Lincolnshire, because obviously. You're on the Lincolnshire fence rather than Lincolnshire ponds, so it's very hilly. I think the light part probably just touches on the ponds. So, with that in mind, it's an interesting route. There's a very wide scope of operations that you can cover on this route, which can comprise of steel traffic, fish traffic, parcels traffic, passenger traffic, seaside special traffic, plenty of shunting operations around Immingham and Grimsby, in the docks and steelworks, Scunthorpe's in here as well. So, all things like that considered, it's a very interesting route. It'd be nice to see more people make scenarios for this, especially pertaining to shunting and steel traffic. That would be fantastic. This route, I think, was last updated about 2 years ago, 2017. People go, a slightly older route now. Yeah, but it's still, you know, it still functions. It works really well. It's a very nice route. I've forgotten how to use the brakes on the 31. I put the brakes in far too early there. Oh, never mind. Just get a bit more poke. Come on. This is far too long for the platform at Louth, which is rather annoying. Louth station is quite well depicted, actually, considering this is a freeware route. It's very well depicted. That grey concrete structure there, it won't be an exact match, but there was one there. I've forgotten what it was now, in real life, but yeah, this is accurately depicted as best as possible. Now what I'm going to do is, whilst I'm stopped here at the station and we're loading passengers, I'm going to make a very mad dash to close my curtains because it's just gone very dark here, and turn on some lights because I will go blind if I stare at this computer screen in darkness. Go on, roll forward, roll. Ah, bugger nuts. No, don't roll back. There we go, that'll do. Right, so whilst we're loading passengers, we'll hear my curtains go. And you could say it's curtains for daylight. Oh. What the... Yeah, thank you, human, for walking and morphing straight into my 31. Which will now breed and make an empire of 31s. Look at that, it's beautiful. I mean, if we just zoom out a bit. It's another fair bit of detail for around Louth, a bit of population density. Obviously, unless you're right up close to zoom right, you're not going to notice it. But yeah. Oh, I wonder if that. Certainly, if these screenshots actually have my mouse in the middle of them or not. But I never do know. Anyway, but yeah, just showing how important Louth was. Really, you've got a good shed here. You've obviously got a coaling stave. There's even a turntable as well. We've got a various yard. It's only a small turntable on mine. It's probably big enough to get an 060 tender on, maybe a mogul. Would a Bromson 04 fit on that? Maybe, maybe not, probably not. Maybe, I don't know. I'll have to try it. But yeah, as a whole, yeah, very well detailed and depicted part of the route. Right, we're going to go to bench level now, about there. And we're going to watch this bad boy depart when it's time. You get to see the clagging here, the noise. Now, there is a brake vehicle on the platform, so we should, in theory, get a guard's whistle, which would be very useful. If not, then no big deal. Alright, we're just going to hide this. And you? I don't know if my mouse is showing on screen. I hope it isn't, but move out of the way anyway. Obviously a 3 minute stop at Louth 909 to 912. No tail light on the back, that's an instant call to the signaller. God, that looks and sounds glorious. Okay, so we're leaving. Then let's get this map back on track. Right, so the line, let me just curve to the left, which will be east in this instance. That's not course, so that's famously in
my local area in
Leicester, Massachusetts. It is remembered by railway trips, it's been remembered by railways, it's been left for day, which was one of these trips, but there was like a children's home, basically a charitable organisation that was kind of founded, and every year they used to take a train load. The charter train, I think, for these, something like that, from British Rail. And they used to take children from impoverished or kind of like poor upbringings, poor families, on holiday once every year to the seaside. And they used to stay in a residential home in the neighbourhood. That's glorious. That is absolutely glorious in terms of the view. In fact, I'm going to do a thing. Oh, whoops. fashion. True fashion, even though it's BR blue, I've gone with a dash one with no ETH. And obviously, with it being some service, this would have ETH. Oh no, come on, cross again. Yes! Always feel crossing gates don't close quick enough. Because in real life they would be short, like probably short like this before the journey went through. With them being air brakes, means you can kind of toggle it a little bit. Feather, that's it, you can feather the brake a little bit as well, which is quite useful on such stock locos. With vac brakes, proper operation, you're just supposed to apply and then leave it, sort of thing. Platform's far too short for the train, but we'll try and get the front coaches on as best as possible. Wow, I've not done this section of the line. Wow. It comes with a stage canopy and a cute signal box. That's quite cool. That's an old freeware model, but it still will come up. Running a little bit late, probably because I braked a little bit too early in that instance. But hey, who cares? Now, will it allow me to do it? Because I had this problem before in a scenario. Yes, it will. I was playing a scenario earlier where it was being very funny with me. And I tried pulling more coaches onto the platform in terms of having the loco off the end of the platform. Press T, it wouldn't acknowledge it. So I don't know what that was about. Probably something to do with the markers, but it's freeway route. We have to remember that, but it's just really atmospheric. The whole route is very atmospheric. Here we go. Watch 1, 2, 3. Should be enough to get us started off. So we've got another stop at Willoughby. Actually, we'll just thrash it. Time. Hey, wheel slip. Sand's in. why we've got a big echo on this bit. Must be some weird occlusion. That was quite a controlled stop, so well done me. Some of you won't know, but some of you do know, I've applied recently to become a trainee driver on the main line as part of a job career change within the rail industry, so we'll see how we go. So far so good, touch wood, passed every stage so far, so we'll see. It'd be quite an interesting life change if that happens, but it's something I've wanted to do, something I've always wanted to do. Won't have to drive train sim so much. First be 5 miles, okay, what time we got? 9:39. Yeah, just let this build up a bit of speed first before we whack it wide open. Seems to respond better that way, I think. Also, I believe these vans appear here are freeware as well. Again, quite old, but they don't look too bad. I've seen far worse, actually. I've seen far better, but I've seen a lot worse. There we go, we can open her up a bit more now. This one, the field diverts on the announcement that car accurately scripted, so I'm going to kick in. Where we get that one around 44 miles an hour. station for the moment. Fun fact, that line's still open. There is a level crossing around there, which is not able to be crossed. I'm sorry, what? Dude, it's supposed to be... Jesus Christ. Stop at first beat. Can't you stop there with BG at least? Hope it's not three BGs. Else I'll start singing you win again. That's been off box. Say, what the balls is that in the platform? The sun reflecting off the front threw me off a bit there. Right, I think this time what we'll do is we'll stop with the actual loco on the platform, because I don't know if that's what upset the stop at Alford. Shame that's happened, really. Junction for Spilsby, Skegness and Wainfleet. Yes, that's a very good point. The Spilsby branch is just up here. Spilsby branch didn't live for very long, I don't think. Sadly, single track. I must make a snyer for that and do that. Ah yes, and then Skegness, then you've got the Firsby Triangle. This is where locos used to turn around. Firsby Triangle on the holiday specials, because it wasn't a turntable facilities that did the job really at Skegness or Mablethorpe, so normally meant that the services dropped off, passengers unhooked the stock, came down Firsby light engine, ran around, went back, couple up and away you go sort of thing. After a bit of a layover, or if it was summer Saturday sort of traffic, they would have basically gone back out again somewhere, I don't know where, but they might have just dropped off, come out of Firsby, turn around, go back, and trip back to the train to take the day trip as back somewhere. Right, so we've got 15 miles of absolute pure noise. That's the Firsby Triangle. Start the Spilsby line is just to the right, which I'm just going to go up and look at myself, which is where it's going. This is start of the Spilsby line. I'll see how far it lets me go. But as you can see, single track all the way up. I've been to Spilsby, a very nice little place it is. Just scope it out. I might do a video on the branch lines. Yeah, that's as far as I get. But you get the picture. Not a broad branch line. That's a little bit of Lincolnshire. Interesting history of the Spilsby line now. There is also a famous bridge as well. I can't remember which railway it was, or whether it's one that is the beatings during the later era or not, but it was like that, an independent railway, and then it would be swallowed by Great. A lot of railway history in Lincolnshire. Lincolnshire is a vast county. again, as I can understand, this route is very flat in this part. So you start getting gradients up around it. I ought to investigate at some point, maybe in another video. There's a problem to run. Yeah, I assume a bit between Barbie and Louth, I think quite hilly or just the edge of Barbie. Just on the edge of the, what do you call it, the Lincolnshire bottoms, which obviously can be interesting. A bit between Louth and Barbie, it's very curvy, so that'll be very interesting strong as well. As you can tell, a lot of it is very straight, very flat around the Lincolnshire, but it makes sense because most of it was agricultural land, and it was just blank canvas. So the railway was more obviously the land they required. The railway was just built as straight as flat as possible, which in an engineering sense is the most perfect thing to do for a railway. No tunnels, no gradients, no cuttings, just straight out of the track, on the track bed, plain land. Over many of the, well, sort of big dikes and tidal rivers that are around the Lincolnshire as well. So that's one of the ones that passed over quite a lot further around the Lincolnshire, obviously, because the Lincolnshire vents are lower than sea level. Just give you a quick insight. The kind of austere, typical country station, of very basic infrastructure with just brick platforms, metal fence at the back, little lyside hut, and a goods shed. They didn't go overly elaborate with a lot of these stations, but they were functional. The look was quite interesting, architecture-wise. Compare the likes of some of these stations in Lincolnshire with, say, rural stations in Leicestershire on the London North Western lines towards the main Birmingham, which were originally just wooden platforms, weren't even brick foundation, apart from, say, Hinkley and Needle, the Needle stations anyway, southeast of Lady, Glen Parver, wooden platforms, which was a very bizarre situation. Obviously they were just cheap and effective to build and plastic. The 40-50 year at least period that they were in use, so did the job. water at the last 7 quarters. On drive, actually, quite nice, just over the rock, it's chilly. Just going on. It's a shame that, well, it says it's not helpful for the first one, but it did. So it's supposed to look like a lot of not as far. This route doesn't call it any quick drive itself, though, which is a bit of a shame. It would have been a lot worse in the transport experience than just how long it is. But it would be very useful just to be able to say, go back to it, play up to sort of point or two, lots to climb or something like that. So, but you have to, if you want to do that, you have to set it as a separate scenario. Which isn't a bad thing, you can make it as immersive an experience as you like.
So limited edition, there's thousands of things, and then there's a lot of things. So,
20 going into Boston, so we'll just whack the brakes in a bit. Is that me distant? Yeah, distance off. That's useful, signal to school by tree. I think that's off. This one's off anyway. Yeah, there we go. We're off. He's putting the driver's report to get actual down. retreat. It's a tree bash. Speed a bit and we'll leave it on notch 3. Notch 2. Nah, I need notch 3 really. Okay. Ah, there we go. The yellow distant. I knew this would happen at some point. Is that a fixed distant or not? We'll slow down anyway, just in case. But we'll slow down for 20 zone. About 15 just in case, because it won't take us long to stop on 15. Then again, it could be an approach control. Where is that signal? Oh, it's been pulled off. Okay. Don't know why the day all that happened. There we go, we're just coming into the dying throes of the journey. And it's definitely more than a feeling. Comment if you got that joke. Then it proves to me that you got this far in the video. You'll win a metaphorical cookie for that. What happened to me 20 limit? Okay, obviously 20 didn't happen. Oh well, never mind. Okay, so we've got that signal, so we're going into 1 as we can see on the HUD. Just a touch too much on the brakes, but never mind. a lot of Boston still survives in terms of track work. I don't know if these are the carriage sidings still, but they do store what we call units in Boston overnight for EMT services still in the present day, which is cool. But a lot of Boston, some of the builders are still the same, I think, but yeah. Pretty sure when I visited it was a curved platform, but I could be wrong. There we go. Just bring us to a controlled stop. Oh, okay, maybe just a little bit of too much of a controlled stop. God, the brakes were really good on this. Yeah, it's different from when you say drive class 20 and it's like got no brakes at all. Okay, just bring the signals into view. Come on, can we get a bit more? Oh, come on, let's get. No, don't roll backwards. What are you rolling backwards for? That's evil. That is very evil. I don't know why it keeps doing that. There we go, sorted. So it will come up that it's the end of the scenario soon. So just want to say, it's been fun recording this video, having a nice little drive. Just makes a change from doing a review or anything like line side perspectives, which is a lot of work and a lot of hassle. It's just been nice to go for a little drive, and I'll upload this at some point. So you may not see this in the same week that I've recorded it, but I think you can understand why. But yeah, this is North Lincolnshire route, using the Class 31 Enhancement Pack 31. And some decent carriages. Link to the main articles of DLC in the description below. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Make sure that you engage with me, and we'll see what you'd like to watch. So let me know how I did. Hope you all enjoyed the video, and I'll see you again soon. This has been a Brucie-Magik production.